get the language right tonight.
This Bible that I follow.
Yeah. One, who wrote the Bible?
Oh man, you late. We just
went
over that.
Hold on. I'm not late.
We'll go back over it for you.
I'm not late. I'm over it. One, hold it. Go down. And who was on this earth before? Who was on the earth first? Who was on this earth first? Because you know, this earth is over 17 billion years.
Exactly.
Okay, so who was on this earth first?
Who was on the earth first?
So another, let me.
So I'm trying to ask that two questions so much. The Bible, who wrote it? Who was on the earth first?
Now,
what else you got?
Hold on.
Give me another one.
Hold on. Let me solidify that. Was man here first before woman?
Yes.
Really?
Yes.
So how do you explain the biblical court?
In biblical court?
Yes.
Yes. How do we explain
that to me?
Okay. I'm not going to explain because that would get it into science. But I can explain to you
the author who created it. No, give me the author. I'm going to say it again. We're talking about, see, what you're going about, something that you didn't write.
Right.
Okay? Common sense. What's so common don't make sense to you. Hold it. Slow down before you go to scripture.
But you got 10 questions. When are you going to get a chance to answer, brother?
No. Listen to me.
All right, go ahead.
Slow down, black man.
All right.
Okay.
I'm slowing it down just for you.
Slow down.
Just for you. For the love I got for you, I'm going to slow it down.
Yeah, I do a lot of research.
We do too.
What do I understand?
Yes.
The black people was on this earth first. It'd be at the very beginning.
I agree with that.
Okay. But man was not here first.
Who was here first?
A woman was here first.
Where do we read that?
Okay, if that's where you read it at.
Where do we find that information?
Hold it.
You can't come tell me that you can't prove.
Common sense.
Here's ain't no thing. Common sense,
hold
brother.
It.
Prove all things.
Okay,
that's why we believe it.
Okay, so then,
prove it to me. Where do I go and read about it?
Hold it. I'm gonna show you where I'm at. But so common don't make sense because you reading a word that you had nothing to do.
So where did you get your information from?
Where I get my information from?
You do research. Don't you read when you do research?
Listen to me.
So you read this what somebody else wrote too.
That's right.
Sense ain't so common. You're
right.
Proving it right now,
bro. Right.
If you do research, you gotta read. We're reading. Reading is fundamental, brother. So we have to read. Now, where you read your information from is not where I read my information from. But if you're asking me a question, I'm going to always go back to my source.
What?
So don't ask me no questions if you don't want me to go to my source. My source is the Holy Scriptures of God. I'm going to start from back and work my way up. From the last question you said.
Yeah.
Who's seen God, right?
Who's
that's
seen
a
God?
Question. Read that for me.
There's no man, no woman ever seen God.
Really?
Whoever created the heavens and stars, that means that someone's so powerful, you don't see him unless you're in the spirit.
Okay.
Not in the flesh.
All right. Unless you're in the spirit.
Unless you're in the spirit,
all
not
right.
in the flesh.
Don't run now.
I'm not running.
Because brothers or brothers, dude, they come and run their mouth and then they leave.
Nah, brother.
Stay there.
I'm not.
All right. Good. So now let's dial it, brother. What's your name, by the way?
What's my name?
Yes.
Logan.
My name is Hyam. Nice to meet you, Logan. So now let's get into this. Read that for me.
The book of John, chapter 14, verse 9.
Read.
Jesus saying for tonight.
Jesus said what?
Have I been so long time with you?
Uh-huh.
And he has thou not known me, Father?
Uh-huh.
He that has seen me.
He that has seen who?
He that has seen me.
Read.
Have seen the Father.
If you seen Christ, you seen God. And matter of fact, give me Philippians 2:5.
When you don't know your own history,
what I'm doing is proving to you what
you
I believe. You're not proving
history.
Anything to me. You just running your mouth right now, Logan.
What you doing?
Come
what
with some proof,
what you
Logan.
Doing? Let me tell you something.
All you're doing is running your mouth.
Getting,
read that.
Listen to me,
the
brother.
Book of Philippians, chapter 2 and verse 5.
Read.
Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ
so
Jesus.
So we commanded to have the same mindset of Christ. So now when I look at this brother, I see Christ in him. If I see Christ in him, I'm looking at God. Now give me that in Daniel. Give me that in Daniel. Daniel 7:9.
Bring it up.
Let's shut this down. Logan's coming here with word of mouth. We coming with biblical facts. Read on.
Logan,
bear with me. I listen to you all your 17 questions. Listen.
The book of Daniel, chapter 17 and verse 9.
Read 7.
7 and verse 9.
Yes.
I beheld till the thrones were cast down, and the Ancient of Days did sit.
Hold on. You said nobody never seen God. But Daniel, in the spirit, because you have to be in the spirit, Daniel in the spirit is revealing something to us. Listen up, Logan, read.
It's Daniel chapter 7, verse 9. I beheld till the thrones were cast down.
Read.
And the Ancient of Days did sit.
The Ancient of Days. Now you asking who was first created. But let's get into before that creation. Who's the Ancient of Days? Who was here before days was created? God. God was here before days was created. Read on.
Whose garment was white as snow.
Oh, hold on. Then he had to see him. Daniel had to see God. He said he had a garment on. Read on.
And the hair of his head like the pure wool.
The hair on God's head was like the pure wool. So who seen God? No man never seen God. Read on.
And his wheels as the burning fire.
And he said he saw God on a chariot, what you men identify as UFOs. So God had a garment, and he saw his hair. His hair was white and woolly. That's why Christ said, if you see me, you see the Father. So we all see God, one way or another. Give me that in Psalms 82. I'm going to show you see God. You look at God every day. But God has lost the gods of this earth.
I am God.
So, if you God, what does make me?
Makes you God too.
So you never seen God? So that means you never seen God? See, common sense ain't so common, right, Logan? Common sense ain't so common. Hold on, let me finish. Let me finish making my point. Because we gotta see who's seen God.
I'm gonna let you finish.
82, Psalms 82.
The book of Psalms, chapter 82, verse 6.
Read on.
I have said, ye are
gods. God has said we are gods because we were made in his image.
Right.
That's why Christ was saying, if you see me, you see God. That's the love we're supposed to have for our brothers now. That's why we don't know how to treat each other. We're quick to kill each other because
right.
we don't see God in each other.
Right.
That's why we're ready to stab, shoot, draw blood because we don't see God. Read.
And all of you are children of the Most High.
We are children of the Most High. We was made in his image, Logan. Read.
But ye shall die like men.
But we're not going to just die. God's aren't supposed to die. We disobeyed. Now we are regular men on this earth. We said we are gods. It was at a point of time we were gods. Right now, Logan, you are not a god, Logan.
That's right.
You are not a god. Are you a god, Logan? Answer my question. You are God? Yes. So, Logan, do me a favor. Change the conditions of Philly for me. You are God, right, Logan? Change the conditions of your people today, Logan. Why are you so? You are a hateful God. You must be a God of the other nations.
Right.
That's what you are. You give me that. Psalms 95.
Let me show you
what kind of God you are, Logan. Logan, you put me in the spirit right now, Logan. My job is to cast down doctrines. And when you come with that mentality, Logan, I got to cast it down and bring you back to the ordinance you're supposed to be.
Bring it up! Put the Psalms, chapter 96 and verse 5.
Read that.
For all the gods of the nations are idols, but the Lord made the heavens.
You know what I'm saying? So the God that you professing you are, you just an idol. All right? You are just a God that's an idol God. There's as many gods, but the God of the heavens is the one we're dealing with, Logan. Logan, if you were that God that represents the one of the heavens, we'll be right here changing our state of our people. That's what gods do.
That's right.
Gods change the state of their people. They bring facts to them. If they research and tell them I learned something, what we do, we bring proof.
They hate us.
That's what we do, brother.
All right,
give me Matthew 26, man. I wish you came a little bit earlier, Logan. We'd have the break, but guess what? Next Sabbath, Logan, we're gonna be right here, Logan.
Here's the thing.
12 noon.
You want the diamond ain't part of the Bible. Here's the thing.
No, that's the oracle. That's our instructions. That's what tells us how to live.
Here's the thing. When I asked, we go another way. Where did the Bible come from? Who created the Bible?
We got that to Peter's real quick. Let me do that one to the God closer.
White man's a dumb. He hates you. That's why they up.
We know that.
Doctor is dumb. Put him in jail.
We know that, brother.
Where did the Bible come from?
We know that, brother. The only reason why me and you not seeing eye to eye because you worship a different God. If you would have worshiped the same God, we're saying the same thing, but we worship different gods. That's the only reason why we not seeing eye to eye. You don't believe in where I get my information from because you don't have the same God.
Focus in.
Yes, I just have to edify my brother, too.
I believe in white man.
What it is.
He
is the devil. What he is.
Oh, we agree with that, too. You got that for me? Logan, everybody answer your question.
The book of 2 Peter.
Listen.
Chapter 1 and verse 20.
Read.
Knowing this verse.
Knowing this verse, Logan. Listen. I'm telling you right now.
2 Peter, chapter 1, verse 20. Knowing this first, that no prophecy of the scripture is of any private interpretation.
Read.
For the prophecy came, not in old time by the will of men.
So the prophecy, this book that we're reading here, it didn't come by the will of man. No man decided, look, I'm going to sit down and put this together. How did it come by?
What? Holy men of God spake.
Holy men of God.
As they were moved by the Holy Ghost.
Man wrote the Bible.
So they were instructed. They were instructed by God to do so.
Excuse me. Let me hold it.
Hold it, brother.
Slow down for a minute.
I'm gonna stay in the spirit.
Hold on.
We gotta close up.
Hold on. No, brother.
So I want you to come back next time.
We're gonna be here for you next time. Slow down. See, I don't wanna get. Listen to me. I want you to hear my energy. And I want you to understand my energy. Here's the thing. I heard you go scripture like you always do, like y'all always do.
Yes, sir.
Understand this.
Instructed by the Most High.
Understand this.
Yes, sir.
Okay? You believe in a God, right? Mm-hmm. This God is a human, or this God is a spirit?
It's a supreme being. And he's a man also.
Hold on.
He's a man. That's a supreme being.
So down.
Read that. Logan.
Matthew!
It's going to take long, Logan. Go ahead.
No.
Matthew chapter 26, verse 6.
Uh-huh.
Now when Jesus was in Bethany, in the house of Simon the Reaper, there came unto him a woman having an ambassador box of very precious ointment and poured it on his head. And he sat at meat. But when his disciples saw it, they had indignation, saying, to what purpose is this waste? For this ointment might have been sold for much and given to the poor. When Jesus understood it,
there was no such thing of Jesus.
Why trouble ye the woman? For she has brought a great work and took work upon the
poor.
For ye have the poor always with you. But me, we have not always. For in that, she has brought this ointment on my body. She did it for my burial. Verily I said to you, wheresoever this gospel shall be preached in the whole world, there shall also this, that this woman have done, be told for a memorial of her.
So every time we bring out the Holy Bible, we have to honor this woman that reverence of Christ and his death for his nation. All right, with that, we're going to close up and say shalom.
Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us. Subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.